This is my 23rd year since I came to Washington working for General Kelly. And you know, this is a celebration. It's our birthday. And birthdays are celebrated by family. And we are all family. And as I look around, I see Marines that I served with. I see younger men whose dads I served with. And I see folks that were ahead of me and I try to keep up with. And you know, why are we here today? Anybody think about that? Because Herb called us together? No. We're here because we're proud. We're proud that we had the opportunity to earn that title, United States Marine. And being a Marine is what means most to those of us who earn that title. And as I said, that's what brings us together here in camaraderie today. Whether you served in our Corps for 3 or 30 years, that indelible spirit that goes along with that title Marine is embedded in our hearts. And that's what makes us hurt when one of our Marines is hurt or his family goes through tragedy. And I think that that's what brings us together in bad times. You know, the Commandant's message today highlighted that tragedy that happened in Beirut. And I gotta tell you, I just get goosebumps. That's probably the fifth time I've seen that video in the last week. And that was a bleak time in our country. It was a bleak time in our Corps. But we rallied, we came together. We shouldered that load together. And now as we stand here in peace and security in this great, great restaurant, and we thank the Hickeys for not only bringing this restaurant to this location, but to host us today. While we're standing here in peace and security, we're at war. And we all know when we raised our hands that the ultimate possibility of our service to our glorious Corps and to this great country was combat. Well, there are hundreds, there are thousands of Marines in Afghanistan, Iraq, the Horn of Africa, and other places around the world fighting this global war on terrorism. So I think it's fitting that we, as we gather here, not only to hoist a few and pat each other on the back and tell stories and get better every year, but to pause, reflect, and rededicate ourselves for what we as Marines have done for this great country. You know, I see a lot of people have Marine Corps emblems on their lapels and stuff. You know, that emblem defines who and what we are. It is paramount on a Marine uniform. It is worn above all rank insignia. It is worn above all decorations. And I think that it is, and I know it is, and you feel it is, that it is the emblem of the greatest air, sea, land fighting force the world has ever seen. So I think it's times like this when you put that emblem on your blazer or your suit to come to an event to stop, pause, and remember what all those Marines have gone before us have done to ensure that that emblem remains the most revered emblem. And many of you take a great deal of, should take pride, that you can take credit in being a member of that team that has ensured that that emblem remains what it is. So as we gather today, there are Marines all around the country that are gathering to remember who they are and what they are. And President Reagan said, as you all remember, a lot of people go through life wondering if they made a difference. Well, Marines don't have that problem. And all of you who have earned that title, you don't have that problem because you continue to serve our great country with pride and I know a great deal of spirit. So I wish you all the best. Happy birthday, Semper Fi. All right.